Hello, Kusto community. My name is Ryan Majitimer. I'm a product manager on the Azure SAMP's analytics team. Today, I'm joined by Adi Eldar, who is a principal data scientist on the Azure Data Explorer team. And believe it or not, we're actually going to be talking about machine learning on Azure Data Explorer. Today, Adi is going to be walking us through two things, forecasting, as well as finding anomaly detection in ADX. I'm going to hand it over to Adi. Welcome.
Thank you, Ryan. My name is Adi Eldar, and I am a program manager in Azure Data Explorer. In this session, I'll present you how you can process time series in Azure Data Explorer and how to use it for anomaly detection and forecasting on multiple time series. So let me share my screen. Okay, so let's start by building a time series, a set of time series actually. So suppose we have a table containing records where we have a timestamp and we have multiple dimensions, and optionally we might have metrics. So you can see an example here. We have HTTP requests from different locations and browsers and countries. If we would like to build a set of time series representing the traffic of this HTTP request for different operating systems, we can use the make series function. So to build a set of time series, we feed the table into the make series operator, applying the count aggregation. And the aggregation is done on the timestamp column from the minimum to the maximum times in the table. The granularity is 1 hour granularity. And we want a separate time series for each operating system. And finally, we just render it. So you can see here that we got time series for each of the operating systems. In blue, Windows 10. In green, it's Windows 8, and in red, it's Windows 7. We can see that we have actually 2 weeks of data. These are the business days, Mondays to Friday. This is the weekend. And you can already see that we have some insights just by rendering the time series. We can see that the traffic overnight is much smaller than during midday. We can see that we have minimal traffic over the weekend. We can see that the traffic of Windows 10 is higher than the older operating systems. And by building a time series, we can actually further analyze this time series for anomalies or forecast what's going to be their behavior in the future and so forth. From data structure perspective, the make series operator actually convert and created a new record for each of the partition key. We have here three partitions for the operating systems. For each one, we have, this is the vector of the timestamps. You can see that it's midnight, 1 a.m., 2 a.m., and so forth. We have 2 weeks data over 24 hours. So this is the size of our times vectors. And this is the actual time series that you have seen represented the traffic of each of the time series. Okay. So once we have a set of time series, we have many functions that can be applied on this set. And in this session, I'll just present the two top level functions to detect anomalies on time series and to forecast time series. And in order to do that, I want to present you the model we are using behind the scene for these smart operations. So the model is called a seasonal trend decomposition model. It's a classical model for time series that we improved and make it more robust to noise and to actual data that is ingested into ADX. So what you can see here, first of all, in the query, I created a set of time series, in this case in 2-hour resolution. I selected a single one, TS1, and I called the function series decompose that generated different components. Let's review the components one by one. The first component, this is my original time series. You can see that we have, in this case, 1 month data. So you can see we have 4 weeks, Monday to Friday. We have weekends here, the low traffic. And apart from the seasonality, we also have a trend. You can see that the traffic is going up week over week. The first thing that this decomposition model does is to try to detect the seasonality. ADX detects it automatically. And once we find the seasonality, we create the seasonal components that you can see it in red. It represents what is the expected traffic on every bin, in this case, 2 hours bins on every day. Once we have the seasonal component, we subtract it from the original time series. And for the rest, we look for the trend. So in the light green chart, you can see that we have a positive trend. The traffic goes up week over week. After we detrend the data, we can subtract the trend too. And we are left with the residual component. The residual component, you can notice that its average, it's zero, because we took away our domain knowledge of the seasonality and the trend of the original signal. And when we will run our anomaly detection model, we will apply outlier detection algorithm on this residual component. And you're going to see it in a minute. And the last component, if we add the baseline and the trend, if we add the seasonal and the trend, we create the baseline component, which will be used for forecasting what's going to be the time series into the future. So let's see it in action, first of all, for anomaly detection and then for the forecasting. So for anomaly detection, let me run it and explain what you see here. Okay. So first of all, I created the time series. I selected a single time series, TS1, and I called the function series decompose anomalies. Here I specify what should be the threshold for anomalies, how seasonality should be treated. Minus one means auto detect seasonality, and how the trends should be treated. Line fit means linear regression to extract the trend. By the way, all these parameters are explained in our documentation. And I got the anomalies, the score, and the baseline. And finally, I rendered the anomaly chart. So let's see how it works. So this is the, in red, original time series. And if I check in the anomalies, we can see that we have purple dots for the anomalies. And you might wonder, why are these points anomalous? Because it's in the middle of the dynamic range. But if you recall that we created the baseline behind the scenes, so let's add the baseline and let's zoom in. So what we can see in the baseline component, that the expected traffic on Monday 6 p.m. is the blue line, while the actual traffic is in the red line. So we have here a low anomaly. The actual value is below the expected value. Same for the adjacent point here. If I scroll to the right, here we have a positive anomaly. the traffic is higher than expected on Tuesday, 8 a.m. The expected is the blue line and the actual traffic is the purple line. So it's without this decomposition model, we could never detect these kind of anomalies. And the idea of this model is to understand what is the anomalous behavior on top of the expected behavior for the specific day and specific time of the week. By the way, we can run it at once for multiple time series. So if I just comment this filter of a single time series and run it again, we can see that now we have anomalies for three time series. So this is the one that you have seen. This is another one with a negative trend. And finally, the last one, which is a noisy time series, and still our model detects anomalies on top of the noisy time series. So this is how to run time series on, anomaly detection on multiple time series. And now I'm going to show you how we can use the same model to forecast time series into the future. So for that, we use the function series decompose forecast. And let me run it and explain you how it works. So if we look at the function, so just before we build the time series using the make series function, but unlike the previous example, in this case, instead of create it just from the minimum to the maximum time, I also add in the horizon, which is 7 days into the future. So I created actually, this is the real data of 1 month, and these are placeholder to get the forecast. It's the fifth week for the horizon. And then I call the function series decompose forecast, specifying the time series, and this parameter tell the model how many points on the right part to trim from the training, because we want to train our decomposition model on the real months and score or predict for the fifth week. So we actually need to trim this number of points. Let's look on the result of the forecasting. So you can see in blue, this is the fifth week, which is just forecasting. And if I take off the original time series and I would just show you this 5 week time series, you could never guess that the last week is actually a forecast. And using the forecast model, it's very useful to predict resource consumption, for example, if it's a cloud service or predictive maintenance scenarios and so forth. So this concludes my demo of anomaly detection and forecasting based on seasonal trend decomposition model. There are many more functions of time series in Azure Data Explorer. You are welcome to explore the documentation, and I hope you will use it and enjoy this demo. Thank you very much. Back to you, Ryan.
Well, that wraps up our video for today. Have you used machine learning with ADX? Tell us in the comments. I would love to hear about it. Again, my name is Ryan Majitimer. You can find me on Twitter. You can find Azure Data Explorer on Twitter. AZ Data Explorer. Like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.